Hello my friends and welcome! In this episode I'm gonna talk about the effects in Moho and their use. By the end of this video you'll literally learn everything about them. So let's begin, shall we? Alright, to begin I'm gonna choose a blue color and press S on the keyboard and drag to draw my rectangle. It should be my background, so I'm gonna create a new layer by clicking on this icon and clicking on vector. Now I'm gonna choose the circle and drag from the center. By holding down the Alt and Shift, I can draw a pure circle. Then I hit Q to select my shape and I choose a green color for it. From here, you can choose your effect to apply to your shape. For now, I'm gonna explain the first one, Shaded. If you choose an effect, a window will open. And from here, you can change the light angle, which is gonna determine the direction of the light. So you can change it by dragging on the number or dragging around this circle. Or another way is to type like this. I'm gonna move the window to somewhere around here so you can see the result better. If you want your shadow to cover more of your shape, you can change this number. And as you can see, if we increase this value more, it's like we don't have a shadow here, but we actually have. One thing about Moho is, never trust what you see, even if it's your workspace like this, or preview. Right now, if I click on OK, and hold down the control and press R, you can make sure that your shadow is correct. But it looks wrong in your workspace. To change your effect parameters, you have to make sure that your shape is selected, and then you click on these three dots next to your effect. By decreasing this value, you can have a sharper shadow, or you can increase it to make it smoother. If you want your animation to look more realistic, then add blur to it. Or for example, if your shape doesn't have a hard surface, then adding some blur to your shadows should be the best option. But if you have hard surfaces, or you want your animation to look cartoonish, then decrease this value. By using shadow color, not only you can add shadows to your shapes, but also you can add some highlights. I'm gonna click on OK. Let me set this to 0. And then I'm gonna click on OK again. And now by holding down the control, I'm gonna press R. See? Let me close this window and go back to our effect. And let me change this color to black. And here we have shadow only. If I click on it and click on OK and press Ctrl R, you can see that it removes the fill of the shape and we'll have the shadow only. I'm gonna close this window again and click on these three dots. Now I'm gonna explain the threshold. To explain this one, threshold, I have to say that this option is completely related to blur option. So first let's increase this value and click on OK. If I hold down the control and press R, you can see that we've increased the blurriness of our shadow. Let me close it again and go back to three dots. By checking the threshold and click on OK, we can see that in these parts that are closer to the edge, the shadow is not blurred. But if we get closer to the light, we'll face a little blurriness. I'm gonna close this window again. And this time, let me increase the value of blur more and more. And click on OK and render our project by hitting the Ctrl R. You can see the blurriness more. Okay, that's it guys. Let me close this window. A common question is that why the effects in the workspace are too different from the effects that we can see in our render preview. The reason is that it helps the software to manage everything. It improves the system's performance and the software's speed. So let's talk about the other effects. Let me close this window. This time I'm gonna choose soft edge. If I click on OK, we can't see nothing. To see the actual result, one way is to hit Ctrl R. So by using soft edge, you can blur your shape from the edges. Let me increase it a little bit. And remove this check and hit Ctrl R again. See? Let me close this. If you really want to see these effects on your workspace, the best way is go to here, click on GPU acceleration. This option might be gray for you, and your system might not support it. So if it's gray, you can update your graphic driver to fix this problem. And to get rid of this window, you can just click on one of the layers. And then as soon as you click on other layers, you can see the result. But if you go back to the layer that contains this circle, you can't see the result at the same time. All right, let me go to the parameters again. If I check the threshold and click on OK and hit Ctrl R, you can see that we still have that blurriness, but it focuses on the edges more and doesn't apply the effect on the places that are closer to the center of the shape. Let me close this again. Next, we have Halo. You should know all of these options by now. You can change the radius of it, or change the blurriness, or change the color, or remove the fill and keep the halo. Is there any difference between this option and shaded? Absolutely. This effect is not a circle, it's a diamond. See? So now if I click on OK and click on another layer, we can see our effect. Let's go back to our main layer. And now let's talk about gradient. I'm gonna move the window to the right a little bit so you can see the shape better. Right now, if I click on OK, you can see that it creates a gradient and it contains three colors, white, green, and black. You can move your gradient by dragging on this point, like this. And if you want to scale it, you can drag on this point. See? If you hold down the shift, you can change the scale of it in this axis. And now I'm gonna release the shift key. And by dragging it around the other point, we can rotate our gradient. See? You can also rotate it every 45 degrees by holding down the shift key when you're closer to one of these angles, like this. Or let me move this circle to somewhere around here. And then I hold the shift, and it snaps to that angle. See? For now, let me move this circle to the center of the circle and move the other circle to somewhere around here. Then we click on three dots. And if I change this color by clicking on it and click on this color, or another way is to double click on that color, you can see that we can change the color of our gradient. I'm gonna click on OK. I'm gonna move this window to the right again. If I hold down the Alt and drag on one of these colors, we can duplicate the color. And now here our gradient looks sharper than before. The more distance, the smoother it will be. To select the color, there is actually a triangle at the top of the color. If you click on that color, it turns black. To remove a color, you can select it by clicking on it. And you can make sure by looking at the triangle at the top of it. And now if I hit the delete key, I can remove that color. This type is called linear. So basically this line is gonna be this line and it applies every color to that line. You can change this type to something like radial. I usually use this to apply the color to the cheeks of my character. If you want to keep the red color and remove the rest, you can click on here. I'm gonna drag on this option and release my click on here. After that, I click on here, drag on this and release it on here. And then I double click on this color and reduce its alpha to something like 0 and click on OK. And then I click on OK. If I hit Ctrl R, you can see that the fill of our shape is still at the back of our gradient. I'm gonna close this window. To remove it, we have to click on our gradient and check allow transparency and click on OK. And then we'll have only the gradient. So you can play with all of these parameters and make one of these and put them on the cheeks of your character. Note that it was just an example and you can do a lot of things using gradient. Right now we have three colors, but you can have as much as you want. Also, you can remove all of these colors. So let's click on type again. This time I'm gonna select reflected and uncheck allow transparency. Let me change these colors to white. And click on OK. Using this option, you can make reflection. Like imagine that it's a kind of jewelry, and when the character moves, you're gonna see a reflection that comes from one side to the other. I'm gonna hit Ctrl Z again. By the way, you can animate this actually, like this. See? And one thing about this is that you have to work on the frame 0, because if we were on this frame, for example, and we were changing these colors, click on OK, you can see that the color is also changing here. So be careful with it. And another thing is that if we change the effect and click on OK, the keyframes will remain. So don't forget to remove them. I'm gonna go back to gradient and click on OK. Let's delete this and move this one to here. And the last type is angle. If I click on OK, let me move this to here and scale it a little bit and hit Ctrl R. It applies the colors of our gradient around the circle. I'm gonna close this. The next effect is image texture. I'm gonna click on it. Using this option, you can choose a texture for it. And let me click on OK. We still have this line, so you can move your texture by dragging on this point. And you can also change the scale of your texture by dragging on the other point or rotating it. So let's say we scale it a little bit to see the repetition of our texture, and we go back to the effect. If we check this option, it doesn't repeat it, see? But by using tile, it copies our texture next to it to fill all over the shape. So let's say we check this. Now the background color is gonna be the color of our fill. If we want our shape to be transparent, we can check this option. And now it only shows the texture. Here you can see the name of our texture. If you want to change it again, you can click on it and select your other textures. I'm gonna click on OK. The next effect is drop shadow. I'm gonna click on it. Okay, you should be familiar to all of these options. If I click on OK and click on other layers, I can see the result. Basically, if you're familiar with Photoshop or Illustrator, you should know that shaded is inner shadow, soft edge is feather, and drop shadow is the drop shadow. Let's go back to the main layer. Then we have crayon. If I click on it and click on OK and hold on the control and press R, you can see that using crayon, it simulates your drawing as if you're drawing it with a crayon. I'm gonna close this window and go back to this. By changing this value, you can change the size of your crayon. For example, let me type something like 2 and click on OK. And if I hit Ctrl R, you can see that we have less width. Let's go back to the effect. By the way, if you want to increase this value to something like 100, you should have a great system to handle it. So don't try to change it that much. And because we draw our shape using a crayon, it leaves a lot of empty space between the lines. The more you have density, the less empty space. And the less density, the more empty space. See? Let me close this window. If I check Erase to Background and click on OK and press Ctrl R, it tries to fill the empty spaces using a white color. I'm going to close this and uncheck this option. And let's set it to something like 0.9. And let's render this project. To export this animation, you have to go to File, Export Animation, set your format to video, choose your address from here. I'm gonna choose Desktop, and click on OK. You can see that our shape is moving, and these lines are jittering. If you don't want them to jitter through your animation, you can go to Effect, and check this option. Minimize frame-to-frame randomness. And now if I click on OK and try to render my project and click on OK, you can see that they don't move. That's it. Let me close it. Click on Yes. And let's see what else do we have here. We have legacy effects. It's not actually an effect. It's the name of this section. These two are actually some of the old effects that Moho had in its previous versions. And because the creators of the software wanted to support previous versions of Moho, they kept these two effects. You still can apply them to your shapes, but if you rotate your whole layer, or if you have a bone or something, by rotating your bones or your layers, they're not gonna rotate. If you scale the whole layer, they're not gonna scale. Or by changing the parameters, Moho is not gonna create some keyframes. Therefore, they can't be animated. But these effects follow your layer parameters. Using this one, you can apply a texture like this. Let me increase the scale of it so you can see them better. And if I change the contrast of it, you can see the texture by clicking on OK and press Ctrl R. You can see the effect. Right now this texture is black and white. And also, let me change the color of the shape to something like white. Right now the color of our shape is black and white. We can change it to something like multicolored. And if I click on OK and press Ctrl R, you can see different colors all over the shape. This effect was called splotchy, and the other effect is called spots. Using this one, you can apply a texture like this to your shape. By changing this number, you can convert these particles to spot. Let me increase them. You can change the width of them or the length of them, see? Or even the space between every particle, like this. You can also rotate them by dragging around this circle or dragging on this number, or click on this number and type something. And using this, you can change the color of every spot. And that's it. By now, you should know how to work with all of these effects. But what if we want to use all of these effects more than one time? Or what if we want to use multiple effects? You'll find the answer of this question in the next video. Thank you so much for watching, guys. If you've enjoyed this video, don't forget to subscribe, and see you in the next one.